Alright, boys, we back. We back. I don't know if I said I wanna do side quest, but I do wanna continue story so bad.
Shall we begin?
Okay.
Then off we go. Now we follow the cave where it leads, deep as it will take us. Has Nanaki told you anything about his parents yet?
No. They were watchers, both of them. But they couldn't have been any more different. When our village came under attack, my mother fought with courage, with honor. She faced the enemy and laid down her life to save us. My father, though, he turned tail and ran. He was a coward.
So then, you still haven't forgiven him?
Why would I?
I see. From this point onward, only two may proceed. He who shall undertake the trial and his observer.
Who's gonna observe?
I'll do it.
That would render the trial meaningless. But if not him... Ah, you'll do nicely.
Me?
Him? Really?
At least pretend not to hate me.
Whenever you're ready.
Ready.
Alright, let's go.
Make sure that you are well prepared.
You gonna watch my back?
Yep. Burning holes in you right now.
What is this?
This is a place of deep sorrow. A place where those who have been
We got this coming. You just float yourself up into another.
As if I were going to already.
Bring your might to bear! Elmer's just gotta stay the course.
Your discomfort is only natural. Yes, the battle was waged here. And even after 45 years, scars remain fresh.
What? You're saying the Gii managed to make it all the way up here?
Okay, somebody. Where'd you run off to? I only got two legs here, you know. Damn if that doesn't look convenient.
We don't have a sass.
I'm gonna make you regret this. Suck on this. One shot at a time. Time for a serious ass whooping. Bang bang! Don't go to that asshole!
Next,
you
next.
Got this.
My turn. Bring your might to bear.
I only got two legs here, you know. Hey, where'd you run off to? What the hell is that?
That is a key.
It's huge.
Under normal circumstances, I would stress that you mustn't judge a book by its cover. For the key, however, they're as fearsome as their appearance implies.
These are the things that killed my mom?
Nanaki. This shall be your first trial. You are to explore this place. Understand the nature of its history.
Okay, will do.
is not the relic.
That is but a mere bone. Poison that rapidly circulates through the body, slowing the wounded until they are completely turned to stone. Yes, an armor. The carvings on its hilt should look familiar. Indeed, you'll find the very same markings on your own body.
That
specter you thought was a fallen key.
Why the fuck are you up there?
Even in death, their lingering enmity manifests as such. They who wander in search of retribution.
That's kind of pathetic.
Do not be so quick to denigrate your enemies, nor make light of their plight. Consider this statue. It has been placed in this chamber for a reason. Handle it with the utmost care.
I will.
Deliver unto us the remnants of our past.
Thank you.
answers?
Interesting. Because my first thought was, are we going to make it out of this place alive?
Its decor is indeed the opposite of inviting.
These look like the statue I picked up.
If there is a reason for everything, then one could argue that everything has no reason. Regardless, you know what you must do, don't you?
Deliver unto us the remnants of our past. Restore them to their rightful place.
Not in the least.
Alright, so we have to find the other one. Cool.
I only got two legs here, you know.
Found it, I guess.
Only a watcher's work is never done.
The Vale is intertwined with the Gi, for they first came to these lands many millennia ago. This sanctuary is proof of their persistence, for it was built to ensure that they never escaped.
But if they were sealed away thousands of years ago,
How'd they break out and attack the Vale?
That I cannot answer. Only the Key themselves could. But enough about them. You are here to learn about yourself, Malaki. This cave serves as a boundary between our world and that of the Key. It was vital to them and their plans. Were the Key to seize control of it, the canyon would be doomed.
And the people.
When the Key moved against us yet again, a certain watcher recalled this vulnerability.
Huh?
Since time was of the essence, he entered the cave without reinforcements. As he had feared, it was teeming with Key, ready to descend upon the village. Determined to protect the Vale, he pounced from one foe to the next, felling all who dared oppose.
Hold on. If there was a watcher who single-handedly saved the canyon, how come I've never heard of them?
For now, you should focus on your own struggles with the Key. Their malice is more potent.
So how are we supposed to open this thing?
How indeed? Ideas, Nanaki?
Let's dig it up with that. Burn it all!
Said pull the chain, I suppose there we go. But what's oh this chain. Lol. Whoa. Okay. Damn. That must be a weak ass gate or you got some strong teeth. A bow. Your sister's an archer, you know, you like. Here we go again. I said three of them. Okay. Easy peasy, no problem. This reminds me of Baldur's Gate.
There is a similarity, yes. But this sanctum is much more ancient and serves a rather different purpose. The altars we came upon before were built to imprison the key. This, however, was built to provide the Cetra with a means to commune with them.
Commune with them? Why would the Cetra do that? The Gi were the enemy.
Good and evil, friend and foe. Dichotomy is not set in stone, as beautiful as the winds. But for now, Nanaki, let us concentrate on the matter at hand, clearing a path to the truth.
consumes many of them. 45 years ago, a Watcher fought his way here alone, and in his bravery took upon himself the burden of our hope.
What the fuck?
Why the hell is this thing pissed at us? Suck on me!
Anguished crossing. Lord. You just take all the hits, yeah. What? He said I can heal the enemy. What the fuck? Oh, okay. Coming stuff is on. Good save, good save.
Fire in one off!
No. Let's go. Holy shit, I don't know. Finally, but I took a damn time just then. Can't take much more. Let's go, let's go. But it doesn't seem good. We got a timer or something? Oh, great. Okay, we got a time to finish this. Serious? Mm-hmm. Oh, fuck's sakes. I hate when this shit happens right at the fucking end, man. My god. Damn. Oh my god, fucking... Here we go. Here we go again. Basically just do whatever we were doing before. You just have to do damage. Fucking serious? Jesus Christ, we're already starting even worse. Don't worry, I got you. Alright. This is even worse, man. Fuck that. I'm not. Start again. Oh, I just felt like a bed icon. Did I? How the fuck did I miss this? What? Did I? How the hell did I fucking miss this? Okay. Whatever. All right then. Now it's gonna be even. Actually, fair fight. That's fine.
Talk about an axe to grind.
How fucking does this shit, man? Seriously, like, I'm gonna go with that stupid bullshit.
Right here!
won't be nothing left of you when I'm through.
No, we got this. We got this. That's why they did not save Barret. Like, what the fuck are we doing, man? Seriously, like, Red, what the fuck are you doing?
Here goes!
on, y'all, come on, y'all, we got this thing. Fucking get up, I'm about it, like, seriously. Good thing he missed that. Jesus fucking Christ, oh my god. Now that was a boss fight, goddamn.
Become quite the formidable fighter.
Sure have. So, does this mean I passed the test?
I'm afraid that decision is not mine alone to make. Let us consult with one more qualified. The Watcher of the Vale fought valiantly and offered up his life in defense of our home. As you see, he still watches over us to this very day.
Wait, is that Seto? My father? No, there's no way.
The poisoned arrows of the Gi transformed his body into stone, and there he has stood ever since, his watch eternal, our savior.
What about my mom? Did she know what had happened to him?
Why, of course she did. It was, after all, she and Seto who asked me to seal off the cave.
But why? Why did she never tell me the truth?
Because she knew that if she did, you would attempt to seek your father out all by yourself. Your parents strove to keep our Vale safe. But there is one thing they fought even harder to protect. You, Nanaki, their son.
She was afraid because I was too small and weak.
Back then, perhaps, but not anymore, heavens no. You've become a fine warrior in your own right. And that is precisely why I brought you here. But this is not where your journey is meant to end, my dear boy. You must leave the Vale once more.
But I'm a watcher now. I gotta protect our home, like he did.
Listen to me, Nanaki. When I first heard your friend's emphatic warnings, I dismissed them outright. No more than the ravings of misguided youth. When you've lived as long as I have, you start to believe you've seen it all. That no surprises remain. But I realize now how very foolish I have been. The eyes that I thought saw the world clearly have grown blind to new possibilities.
But
I would hate to impede your progress any further. I bid you leave, Nanaki, before, like me, you become inured to your own ignorance. with sharper eyes and keener ears. Go forth, and in my stead, seek the great truths of our world. Look after him for me.
Don't worry. We will.
You failed this trial, my boy. Continue your training and try again. Are you up to the task, Nanaki?
You bet I am. After all... I am Nanaki, Watcher of Cosmo Canyon, and son of Seto, Protector of our Vale!
Goddamn, okay. Is you.
My name is Gi Natok. O brave and noble Seto, I beseech you once more, hear the urgent pleas of my people. My thanks, Seto. You are as magnanimous as ever. The warrior Nanaki, and you, the Cetra. Come with me.
That was...
How about no?
Turn of events indeed.
We'll back you up, Patuta.
Who the fuck? What the fuck? Okay. So, well, of course, Cloud's gonna follow now.
No. This one's free.
Explain to me why we're even taking this detour? Anyone? Because some of us are on a mission to secure the material we need to, you know, save our homeland.
How can you talk like that in a place like this? I'm scared of Emma. What's here?
I don't know. This Gi dude's too nice to freak me out.
He may act nice, but who knows what he's planning. Stay alert.
The home of the Gi lies beyond. Now let us begin our journey.
Not so fast. What's in it for us? Unless it's materia, you can count me out.
How strange you should mention materia. My people are also in search of it.
Okay, all aboard!
Fucking crazy brainstorm.
Longer if I could, but I'll be back soon. I promise.
Thank you. I'm gonna hurl.
Maybe try swaying with the rocking of the boat?
I wanna move less, not more.
Didn't seem to mind when you jumped aboard.
Well, only because he mentioned materia.
Be quiet. The planet is listening.
And what's wrong with that?
Anything that reaches the planet's ears, in due time, reaches those of the Cetra. Unfortunately, the Cetra are not a tolerant people.
Excuse me, am I intolerant too? I'm Cetra.
You are indeed one of them. By lineage alone.
But you don't have their culture.
You know not of their history. That has been lost to time.
Their history?
Consider your ignorance a blessing. The Cetra's past is fraught with horror and sorrow.
So there I am,
on the ground, bleeding out, watching everything go dark. Thinking, this is it. This is how it ends. Only, it isn't. Suddenly, the wind picks up out of nowhere. It tugs at me so hard, it feels like it's tearing my soul right out of my body. Next thing I know, I'm back in the orphanage. But nobody can tell me who found me or how I got there. It's a miracle.
Sounds like what happened to me. Whole freaking army unloading on my position. One minute, I'm outnumbered, and the next, I'm alone.
None of it makes any sense. I somehow managed to beat the odds and wake up here, alone. Why in the hell did fate pick me?
Can't think that way.
Can't not think that way. Their luck runs out, but mine doesn't. I'm the only one who gets a pass. And now that it's just me, what am I supposed to do? You know?
Yeah, I get it.
Hey, come with me.
Sure, but why?
I'll explain on the way. So, how's Cloud holding up?
Mako poisoning's done a real number on him. Doubt he's in for a speedy recovery either. But hey, hope springs eternal.
Right. If he does recover, you can bet your ass he'll act like it was nothing. Shrug it off and say he's been through 10 times that shit.
Are we talking about the same Cloud?
Come on. The guy's desperate to prove himself. Not like he needs to. Everyone knows he's a bona fide badass.
Is this Biggs from our timeline brought over to here?
Why?
Because one's not enough.
I'll think about it. It's true.
Bro, they keep messing with us, bro, but like...
Okay, let's see. The destruction of Sector 7 was orchestrated by Shinra themselves. We can't let those murderers get away with it. People of Midgar fight back against our corporate oppressors by joining Avalanche. Seek us out at the lot off Petal Lane. Wow, that's bold.
Yep.
These guys are setting a trap for themselves. Shinra will just roll in and round them all up.
Doubt public security will even bother going through the motions. Easier just to shoot and skip the paperwork.
Then anyone who goes is...
an idiot, I know. But idiots are what we need right now. Folks will risk it all.
Wait! Don't tell me you're going! The things I do for friends.
I kinda wonder how that river looks to all the folks topside.
Hey, you ever wondered about your purpose in life? What you're doing here?
Sure, from time to time. Or all the time.
Would never have guessed.
Didn't used to, but
it's
things changed. Went through a lot after I joined Shinra, like, a lot.
I bet. I ask, because ever since I woke up, I've been wondering about what to do with all this time I've been given.
Hey, Biggs. You said before I ought to try picking up some work as a merc.
Yeah?
Because one's not enough. So who's the one?
Cloud. He didn't tell you? Must not have wanted the competition.
When exactly did you meet Cloud?
This Biggs is from our fucking timeline.
How long ago was that again? Weird. My internal clock's busted.
Yeah, mine too. What's that about anyway?
Good question.
Yo, this is wild. Biggs is from our fucking timeline and he was brought here. What the fuck?
Treat you and yours to something special, but remember,
you know,
only one per person.
Mm-hmm. I think I prefer being number two or three. Suits me much better.
Yeah.
Why don't we all go
camping? Like the guy who only has to worry about the how doesn't have to decide on the what.
A minor role?
Exactly. I'm no hero. So how come I was the one who got saved?
Because someone needs you. You and your can-do attitude.
And who might that be?
You were the guy with Aerith, right?
Whoever brought you back, I guess?
And assuming there was someone, who could it have been?
That's a good question.
Hell with it! Let's just do what we want! Start back robbing folks and stuff.
It's just up ahead. Keep your eyes peeled.
Copy. Nobody, huh?
Not a soul.
Well, at least Shinra was a no-show too, right? Who's there? Huh. New recruit?
As if I'd ever joined Avalanche. I just came to see what kind of morons would fall for your dumbass propaganda, that's all. But I should have known. Nobody could be that stupid. Anyway, I'm out, losers.
I told you I wasn't cut out for a leading role. And here I thought I might have been saved for a reason. Some higher purpose. Sorry for wasting your time.
It's up to us to find our own purpose. I mean, who says it's gotta be one way? Everyone's sitting back, acting like the world's doomed, but the future's not set in stone. We're not powerless. So long as we don't lose sight of what's important. You know, what matters most of all when the going gets tough. I don't know, hopes, dreams, maybe? Something like that. So long as we've got those. And hold on tight and never let go.
Like this?
Like your life depends on it.
The world's lucky to have you. It's a start. Anyway, I gotta run. I'll be sure to pay a visit to Cloud when I get the chance.
See ya. Think about what I said. Guess I should probably head home too. Home, huh? Back.
Welcome home.
Welcome home.
Guess who I just saw? Biggs.
Really?
Said he'd visit too.
Oh yay! Did he say anything about Daddy or Tifa?
No, sorry. Forgot to ask.
Aww.
Zach, would you mind checking on Aerith for me?
Sure.
We're all headed for the same place. You'll see your daddy and Tifa again.
Soon?
Soon enough, Marlene. Soon enough.
Me. The wind, that was you, wasn't it? Hello in there.
Welcome to the village of the Gi.
just now?
Our flesh is gone, yet our spirits are condemned to linger. Outsiders such as we are unwelcome, forever denied the planet's embrace.
I feel for you. Can only imagine how tough that's been.
My kin now dwell within these effigies. I beseech you, lend them your ears. Long has it been since they have had an audience.
They're not bound to the planet, and so she rejects them.
Because you have to come from the life stream to return to it.
Which means these dudes can't die, right? They're invincible!
I'm not sure that's something to celebrate. Being stuck as spirits with no hope of release sounds like a fate worse than death.
As if you know anything about dying. I mean, are you even really alive?
Another stuck spirit, perhaps?
We shall not rest till the materia is ours.
You and me both.
Yeah, this thing is fucking with sound, like, what the fuck? We're going back to claim. Actually, that's how we're supposed to claim.
Salvation is cessation. It is nothingness. Our wish is not to exist, but rather to no longer exist.
Ultimate salvation is nothingness? Okay.
In the purest of materia, we place our hope.
Y'all, but I got a sinking feeling. Think we probably don't want to overstay our welcome here.
It's hard to feel at ease around folks whose only desire is death. And if the planet won't let them have it, well, who's to say they won't let the planet have it?
Save me!
Sure.
Don't you think someone responsible like me ought to hang on to that materia? So it doesn't fall into the wrong hands.
I think we shouldn't get involved at all, Lassie.
Little late for that.
Ah! Ah!
What do you think he wants us to do for him?
Steeped in our one desire, purest of material no more, with pain and spite made black. Steeped in our one desire, purest of material no more, with pain and spite made black. Steeped in our one desire, purest of material no more.
Yo, Cloud, what the fuck's going on?
Steeped in our one desire, purest of material no more, with pain and spite made black.
Whatever that materia is, we can't let them have it. No matter how much they want it. Don't know how far we can let this go, but for now we play along.
What the fuck? I don't get any good data in this constant.
Let's go! Hey! You're up! Do it!
Damn, these guys are fucking us up, man. What the hell?
Those not born of the life stream can never join its flow. One cannot return to that from which one did not arise. And so our souls sought refuge here. Yet idleness brought no solace. Our days, a penance imposed by the planet for the sin of our existence. And now, our only wish is to be freed from this prison, to be granted true release. From the planet, we claim the greatest of materia, a most sacred treasure, and imbued it with our desire for freedom. After an eternity, the materia began to stir, and thus did we rejoice, knowing that salvation was within our grasp. We rejoiced, so convinced were we that our prayers for release had not been in vain. Yet the loathsome Cetra trespassed upon our lands and stole the treasure that would grant us deliverance. Therefore, we ask that you retrieve it, the Black Materia, key to our oblivion. Please, it alone can liberate us from this endless dream. The Gi cannot rest until our sacred treasure has been restored to us. Moreover, in redressing the crime of her ancestors, the Cetra may help us to let go our ancient grudge.
Where is it?
It is said the orb lies within a place of Cetra worship.
A place of Cetra worship? Or temple?
You know what?
I have an idea. At least, I think I do.
Forgive me, Hollow One, if I regard you with suspicion.
Now hold on there. I'm friend to one and all, thanks to my crystal ball. No matter your need, I have the right read.
He's strange, but you can trust him. Really.
Alas, it appears we have been discovered. I trust you will return our materia to its rightful home. Only you can end our torment.
I guess we're back?
Yeah.
We need to get moving.
Right!
I'll make you proud, Dad. Just wait.
It's good to see you again. Allow me to escort you to fellow Bugenhagen. Please, this way.
Hook, line, and sinker. Those undead suckers actually think we're gonna give them back their materia!
They called it their salvation or whatever. But to me, it sounded more like something with the potential to wreak some serious havoc. Nope. No way in hell.
Can't let him have it either. Sephiroth. Did no one else sense him?
No.
Well, you're the real expert. If you say Sephiroth was there, I'll believe you.
Wait. So, are you saying Sephiroth's after the Black Materia too?
Probably. Better to assume he is.
Well, come on! Let's go! Can't let anyone get between me and my Materia!
So, Kitsu, I gotta ask, how do you know about the Cetra Temple anyway?
I wouldn't say I know about it exactly. Not directly, anyway.
What's that supposed to mean?
I just recall some document or other discussing its existence. If we can get to a Shinra terminal, I should be able to find it again.
Terminal, huh? They set any up here?
I think so. But I bet old Boogie will know for sure.
You might have returned to the planet.
Oh, come on. We both know you didn't need to worry about me. After all, I am the son of Seto the Watcher.
Forgive me. But if I recall correctly, Shinra should have set up a transmission terminal here in Cosmo Canyon, so where is it?
Oh. What did become of that thing? Ah, yes. Now I remember. I was so fascinated by the technology it employed, I did some tinkering. Some tinkering, I say, though it was quite a lot. But now it serves a decidedly more practical purpose.
You've got to be kidding me!
Well, do you know about a Cetra temple?
A temple, you say? If you mean a place where they worshipped gods, none exist. The Cetra never engaged in such practices.
I didn't know that.
Maybe it was referred to as such by someone ignorant of their culture. If instead it is a site of importance to the Cetra that you seek, texts do speak of one, and of the pains taken to conceal it.
So, it does exist?
Perhaps, though I know not where it is.
Huh?
And even should you find it, I would urge caution. They were a star-crossed people. To follow in their footsteps is to court tragedy. However, the rewards may yet outweigh the risks. You must bring every one of your senses to bear. For then no secret will elude you, however well hidden. And when you return home, I hope you'll share your discoveries with me.
Fellow Bugenhagen!
What is it? I'm a little busy here.
Another man in a black robe has come. What should we do?
Well, now, a friend of yours?
Where'd you see him?
Oh, the village gate.
We should check it out.
Yeah.
Blessings of the planet be upon you. Are you in need of guidance?
Nanaki!
Is this man okay?
He is, albeit rather weak. Not sure why, though. I know Mako poisoning when I see it. And this isn't it.
Nibelheim ain't bad.
Her Tifa and I grew up.
Oh, of course.
Going back home.
Nibelheim has a terminal. I'd bet my whiskers on it.
It, had a terminal.
Cloud. Remember when you told Gein Attack back there? That I might be weird, but you can trust me. Aye, well, even if you were lying, I'm gonna prove to you that you can trust me. That I'm on your side.
It's not that.
We should go.
Hey!
Wait, you're talking about heading to Nibelheim from here? There's no roads you can take, far as I know.
Good point.
Maybe we can't go by land.
But by air.
Meaning we'll need smoke.
Seed. We need you, seed. Where you at, seed?
Cloud. Proto-relic energy signature confirmed. And relatively close to you. While the signal is on the weaker side, it may serve as a good place to start. I'll send you the coordinates right away.
What happened? Is he okay?
Fuck the side quests, man. I can't be bothered. I just wanna continue this. This is too good.
Not that you've got a choice, but thank you for choosing Bronco Airlines.
Sit, my friend. You couldn't give us a lift in Nibelheim, could you?
A little far. But not too far, I reckon. The old girl should be more than up to the challenge.
Can I cross this? Is that like possible? Like, what's the point of me controlling this? That wasn't that fun. Lol.
I'll see you when I see you.
Hey, Sephiroth, wait up.
Bring me the black materia.
What the fuck? Okay.
You okay?
Yeah.
Looks like we're not the only ones headed for Nibelheim.
Huh. Almost like they swung by Cosmo Canyon just so they could lead us here. Sorry, just thinking out loud. Forget about it.
Ooh, Odin on this, huh? Cool. Damn, bro. This shit is wild. So many mobs. So big. So much things to do. It's fucking crazy.
Kate? Meant to tell you before, but the terminal's probably gone. Nibelheim burned down 5 years ago.
Not to worry, though. The terminal is as snug as a bug in a rug. Because Shinra wasn't about to let that facility burn down.
Meaning the reactor?
Some bubbles? fuck?
Billy? What are you doing out here?
I haven't had much luck at the racetrack lately. Not the good kind, that's for sure. So I came here to train.
Train? Here?
You don't know where you are? This is the home of the Chocobo Sage, a living legend. Surely you've heard of the man.
Did someone say living legend?
Yo, what the? Won't be a living legend for long.
I am now. Thought I was a goner.
Huh?
Mind telling me who you are? I don't get many visitors out here in the boonies.
This is Cloud. He's a jockey for Gramps' ranch.
Oh, he is, huh? Perfect. Billy here needs some help. He can pick up the poor boy's slack.
There's this big race at the Saucer, the Gold Cup, and it's coming up soon. We gotta get in on that, so I came here to bone up. I'm learning all sorts of stuff. See?
Hey, tell me you're not buying this choco dung. Picking garbage out of a pool isn't training, it's manual labor. You see it too, right? So weird. Come on, he's just jerking you around.
I suppose I haven't done much to pick up after him.
If you can flap your gums, you can move your gams. Now get on back to your training.
Sorry.
As for you, I know just the thing. One of my chocobos ran off when we put her out to pasture. Need you to find her. Bring her back.
You're asking me?
Her name is Selena. Ain't your normal chocobo neither. Loves the ocean more than home. The way she makes rolling waves look like solid ground. No wonder she thinks she's the bee's knees.
Please, Cloud, would you mind? Just think of it as a favor for me? You've got a gift for wrangling the wild ones.
Who exactly?
My old man. Excuse you, it's not funny.
Nibelheim's not far now.
First time back since.
Yep. First time.
Same here. Didn't seem worth coming back till now. Didn't think there was anything to do.
Sorry.
It's all right. Lots happened since then. Cloud, stay close, will you? I honestly thought I was ready for this, but... just too real.
It's okay, baby girl, we got you. Maybe don't stand too close to us, because... who knows, we might have another... episode. Let me try to murder you.
They rebuilt the whole village.
Don't scare me like that. Thought Cloud might have lost it again. I mean, I thought he got us lost, because it looks different. So, who do you think rebuilt it?
Shinra.
Never mind all that. We've got a terminal to find.
Damn, huh? Did they build it, but why? There's not even many people, there's more black robes than people. What the fuck?
Well, shit.
A lot of robes out here.
Yeah. And look. Locals. They aren't quite the same, are they?
Hello there. Can I help you?
Greetings, good sir. I am a proud employee of Shinra Resorts. And since I was nearby, I thought I might pop in and check something on the company database.
And your companions?
Oh, them? They are...
I used to live here until... You know.
I see. And are you aware of what Nibelheim is now?
Nope. No idea.
5 years ago, Shinra assumed direct control over this village. It now serves poisoning. All property rights have been transferred. If that's why you're here, contact Special Facilities at Corporate. They'll be able to help you.
Very helpful. Thank you, sir. Ah, but the database. I'll not be a wee minute.
I'm sure you're eager to see your hometown, but please, don't stay too long.
What the fuck? Oh shit. Bro, we're about to have a fucking stroke.
Soldiers. You were here with me. 5 years ago. You came with me on the mission.
Finally, you remember. Will the headaches fucking stop now?
Thank you.
Yo, we need to tell Lattice.
They're everywhere you look. You don't really think that all these guys decided to get up and shuffle over here of their own accord, do you? Course not. This is Shinra's doing. First, they raise up. Do something, right?
Hell yeah, you're right. Screw them.
That's the spirit. Screw them. We'll make them pay for what they did to y'all's home.
Welcome. Would you...
Safe travels.
Hey, so we gotta talk.
Question. This always been here?
Yeah.
It totally screams, climb me, doesn't it? So, let's give the poor thing what it wants and see the signs.
Hey, you're don't the... just... But don't let Tifa see this. Don't let Tifa see this.
To look at this place, you'd never know.
Yeah.
So, which one's your house?
That one.
Aw, looks cozy. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said that.
No, don't worry about it. It's all new to you. That building right there is the inn. Where I stayed 5 years ago. You got the town hall. The general store. In that there? Tifa's house.
So let me guess. This is where you kept lookout.
Huh?
Come on, you never came up here hoping she'd wave?
Probably. Sounds like something I'd do.
If I was in your shoes, I would have been up here all the time.
I'm gonna head down.
Think I'm good where I am. I'll see you later.
That's not what I meant to say to her.
If you don't mind, I'd like to be alone.
Are you angry?
Mm-hmm.
At me?
Not at you. At everything. Must be nice. To have a friend you've known since you were a kid. Someone you can say, remember the time when, to. Someone you can reminisce with. I don't have anyone like that. And it feels like I'm being taunted for it. Which stings. More than it should. That is why I want to be alone. Plus, I might take it out on you, and I don't want that.
I don't mind.
Well, I do, and it'd only make me feel worse. Thank you, though. Really. I'll be down in a bit. See you then.
You certainly don't look ill. Passing through, I take it. If you are, well, though, you'll have to wait.
You might have been...
lol. We're playing Gwen with the mentally ill. Good stuff.
You know. I never understood it. Why'd my dad go into the reactor? Why chase Sephiroth? Thought about it ever since waking up in Corel. It just seemed like such a bad idea. I mean, what did he think he was gonna do? Fight a famous war hero and win? Well, he didn't. But after moving to Midgar, after making a life for myself, I finally realized where my dad was coming from. He was angry. And he'd had enough. Everything he'd worked so hard for had been destroyed in an instant. All that he'd built for himself, for us, gone. Sephiroth had burned it to the ground. That's why he went, even though he had to have known how it'd end.
I see.
And like him, I took my pain, my grief, everything I was feeling. I took it all and turned it into anger. Anger that led me to Avalanche. The problem is, anger doesn't last. So when Avalanche started to become more violent, there wasn't enough left to hold back the fear and the doubt. It was taking a toll. Then you turned up.
Like it was fate.
Yeah, like it was fate. A lot's happened, but now that we're here, I know this was the right decision. Because now I know they rebuilt everything. Tried to sweep what they did under the rug and pretend it never even happened. But I won't let them. I can't. Sephiroth and his cruelty. Shinra and their lies. I'm sick of all of it. Hey, remember when we were kids? How you'd, you know, always be looking at me?
What?
Every time we made eye contact, you'd look away. And when I tried to talk to you, you'd ignore me.
Not surprised. I was a pain in the ass as a kid.
I was the opposite. I needed everyone to like me all the time. Part of me still does, I think. Kinda hate that about myself. Gotta get it together.
I'm not sure why that is myself. Maybe it's to mark off on the different symptoms?
This is where we care for the patients. We provide checkups, treatments, whatever they need.
Reactor's not too far. Hey, Cloud. Ever been up there before?
Yeah.
Oh? Then give me the skinny. What was it like? Was there buttloads of Mako? What about, say, oh, materia?
Come to think of it, nope.
Nice try. But you can't fool me. I know what you're up to. You want it all for yourself.
Okay. Put your fingertips together.
So. Oh, what a pleasant surprise. Say, why don't you and those robed folks pose for a photo? It turns out that Shinra's in charge getting permission to take pictures. All my photos will be reviewed. Just gotta impress those suits. If you find a good photo spot, don't hesitate to let me know.
What the fuck? Where's Red? Mm. I don't know.
No need to wear yourself out. Let's rest.
It's a big building.
My mom needs to move in with me. I know.
What's wrong, Kate?
I should have known it was too good to be true. I only have limited access from this console.
Let me guess. Limited doesn't cut it.
Nope. But all is not lost. Excuse me, good sir. Would you be so kind as to grant us entry into Shinra Manor?
Don't you have clearance for that?
Oh, if only. I'm but a wee bottom feeder. Barely have clearance to use the bathroom, me.
Be that as it may, I can't let you in there myself. You'll have to ask my boss instead.
Meaning the deputy commissioner? Or the commish himself? Let's meet and greet.
Deputy Commissioner Murasaki is up at the reactor, conducting an inspection for corporate. He's due back the day after tomorrow, but he hasn't been in touch to confirm. Could be he needs more time.
We can't afford to dilly-dally.
Then we'll just have to track him down.
Agreed. Thanks for all the help, pal.
Oh, that's right.
So, you're headed to the reactor, huh?
Headed to the reactor? No luck at town hall, I take it.
Gotta get a key card. A guy named Murasaki has it, but he's inspecting the reactor.
Well then, you'll need a ninja to accompany you. I'm coming with.
Me too.
Really? You sure?
Ask anyone around here. I'm the best there is.
All right.
You sure you're gonna be okay?
We're going on a hike and getting a key card. How tough can it be?
You'll still be gone for a while. Sure there's nothing you need to take care of?
I'm putting you in charge of provisions. But make it snappy. My materia needs me.
Alright, this is where we stop for the day. Tomorrow we shall go see the reactor. Maybe even do like some side thing or something just to be on par with the level, because we're one level under the mission. Fine. See y'all tomorrow. This was a good episode.